Welcome to COVID Cooking, and I'm going to show you a no-maintenance sourdough starter. So you need to have your good sourdough starter, and for some reason, maybe you just want to stop with it for a while. It's taking up room in the fridge. It's getting annoying to kind of have around. So there are ways that you can store it where you have no maintenance issues anymore. So you'll want to feed it, make sure that it doubles, and then you're good to kind of use that. So there are two ways that I like to do it. I get these silicone pads, and you can just kind of scoop out your sourdough starter and smear it all over the silicone pad, and then you just let it air dry overnight. Sometimes it can take 2 nights depending on how thick you get it, and then you're left with these flakes. So you find a container that you can put them in, just kind of break it up and put that in there. Then when you're ready to use your sourdough starter again in the future, all you need to do is mix up your flour and water mixture and then add some flakes to that and feed it a couple of days, and you're good to go until it's back up to doubling strength. Another way to do it that's even a little faster is you can get one of these silicone trays for making ice cubes or whatever. It doesn't really matter what shape it is. And then you take your mature sourdough starter. And I actually like to make it with a little less water than I normally do. I do 50% water, 50% flour. And then I go ahead and put it in here. And then I'm going to put this in my freezer, freeze it. And then I'm putting it in a little baggie. And then when I'm ready to do some sourdough again, I make a mixture of my 50-50 water and flour, and then I would just put one of these cubes in that, leave it alone until you see some activity, feed it for a day or two, and then you're good to go with your sourdough starter. So there's no need to maintain it in the fridge once a week or to keep it out on the countertop if you're not making sourdough very often. It may be that you started gung-ho during the COVID crisis and you were making lots of sourdough, and then the novelty sort of wore off for you, but you don't want to just toss it. You put a lot of work and care into it. This one has been going for about 6 months now for me, so I want to make sure that I don't lose all of that work that I did. So I'm going to be storing my sourdough starter in both forms, and then if one of them doesn't work out, I still have a backup because I don't want to lose all those months of work and investment that I put into it. So you can dehydrate it. You might think, well, that's kind of weird, but actually when they opened up some tubes in Egypt, they found some remnants of this like sourdough starter, you know, yeast, and it did grow after thousands of years. So, you know, a few years in your closet probably isn't going to make a difference. And then again, the frozen one will probably be a little bit quicker. So that's my advice for you. So your easy, no maintenance sourdough starter. Make sure you hit subscribe and like this video and share it with your friends. And thanks so much for watching. Have a great day and stay safe out there.